Oh boy. Oh man, this movie.
Argylle, written by Jason Fuchs and directed by Matthew Vaughn, tells the story of Ellie Conway, a world-famous author who writes a spy thriller novel about Special Agent Argylle, played by Henry Cavill. Kinda. Though, she soon realizes that the plot of her new book is starting to unfold as real-world events in real time. That's explaining the movie extremely simply, because this movie really does have so much going on that a simple one-to-two-sentence synopsis could not possibly ever do justice. And, unfortunately, I think with this movie, that's not really a good thing. I'm just gonna ramble about the movie. So, up front, I'd be lying to you if I said I was a fan of Matthew Vaughn's filmography. But I say that not because I dislike his work or anything, but because I've only seen one of his movies, The First Kingsman. I haven't seen anything else by Vaughn, but I remember loving Kingsman and the Secret Service. It was energetic, fun, stylish, and I thought to be well acted and just well made across the board. But I don't know, I wasn't really interested in watching more movies from that universe for some reason. I couldn't even really tell you why. So I can't really speak to the rest of Matthew Vaughn's movies other than The First Kingsman, but I'll say this about his newest film, Argylle. It's an absolute fucking mess. I so very badly wanted to love this movie, guys. Hell, I even wanted to like this movie, but I just couldn't. It never fully clicked with me. For starters, I think the movie's just overly bold with what it wants to do. And it's crazy because it's still a fairly beefy movie with a runtime of about like 2 hours and 20 minutes or something like that. And there were still numerous story elements that felt rushed and undercooked. The movie is constantly reinventing itself throughout its runtime. Each third of the movie kind of takes on like a whole new vibe, really, is the best way that I can describe it. It felt to me like the people behind the movie had so many different and cool ideas for this espionage-ridden world that they created that they just crammed it all together into one movie, and ultimately nothing feels cohesive or earned. And I mean that when I say cool ideas, because this movie does have a lot of cool shit in it. It's just that so many of these movies' twists and turns, and boy, are there a lot of fucking twists in this movie, don't feel earned. Because as the movie kept trucking along, and these twists kept happening, and more crazy nonsense kept happening, it all did make sense. It did, it just felt really rushed. It's strange because I think this movie is both very well written at times and also very poorly written at times. But I can't really get into that without spoilers, so let's just move on from that fact, I guess. And I usually don't like saying shit like this, but I actually feel like this movie would have been better as a show, like a miniseries or something, or even just broken up into different movies, just so we can let some of these storylines breathe and we can build up more of the characters that we have here. Though, I do think that's sort of the plan with this movie. I mean, Argylle sets up a much larger universe of spy networks, but it sort of feels like they didn't really know if the whole franchise would come to fruition. So again, they just smashed a couple movies worth of ideas together into one movie, and it's sad because I really fuck with these kind of stories. I mean, it's a stylish throwback to spy thrillers of old where our protagonists globetrot and throw down with evil organizations that have ridiculously nefarious plans. I love shit like this, and I do think the movie's got a really good tone. It's vibrant, energetic, filled with assassins and espionage, MacGuffins, and tons of spy movie cliches that are done with love and clear inspiration. And by the end, the movie just completely loses its fucking mind and decides to go balls to the wall insane, and I loved it. The final act has some of the most ridiculous and stylish action sequences that I've seen in recent years, and I loved watching them. Like, this scene specifically had my fucking jaw on the floor. I was truly astonished by what I was watching, and I can't wait to watch clips of it when it hits YouTube. And while I did say the movie does have a good tone, it's just a little bit inconsistent, because scenes like this, I would have rather have been most of the movie rather than some of the movie. That being said, I also really enjoyed the performances. Bryce Dallas Howard's character has a lot to do in this movie, particularly in the second half, and I think she does a great job at portraying this fish-out-of-water type character and how she adapts to the ensuing insanity. Sam Rockwell is fantastic as well, but like, you know, when is he not? I did catch myself in the theater thinking though, like, he's kind of just playing the same guy that he did in The Way Way Back, which is another great movie. You guys should check it out if you haven't.
Owen, settle a debate for us.
Hello, boys. Duncan, this is Vladimir, Ishmael, and Ming Lee.
Those aren't our names.
Those are the names I'm giving you, Vladdy. These are my illegitimate sons. They all have different mothers. I'm trying to be a positive influence in life. Thinking of a little league, boys club, raising pandas to fight.
Shut up, jackass.
Clown fencing, hooker retreats.
Also, I need you to reorder more mats.
Did it.
Finish the work schedule for next week.
Did it.
Change all the filters.
Done.
Right. So you know I'm going to check all that stuff, right?
Oh, well, in that case, I didn't do any of that.
Right, so I'm doing it.
It's called delegation, baby. I read about it in the book about it.
I also thought the rest of the cast was good when they were being utilized, because unfortunately, as amazing as a cast that this movie has, they're so underused. Bryan Cranston, who plays the main villain, looks like he's having a blast in the movie, but he doesn't do anything. Same could be said for literally everyone else. Catherine O'Hara, Samuel Jackson, Ariana DeBose, John Cena, Dua Lipa, Sofia Boutella, and even Henry Cavill. All these wonderful and talented people are giving fun performances, it's just that they're barely in the movie. And listen, I also never complain about a movie's rating. Like, nowadays, the internet's full of fucking bloodthirsty monsters who want every movie to be rated R and full of fucking gore and guts and, you know, what have you. Trust me, if you've ever been anywhere on a film forum or just on social media, you know exactly what I'm talking about. These people are fucking savages. But ironically, here, I kind of agree with the savages. I think this movie would have been a lot better if it was rated R. And without going into spoilers, the movie's action sequences and jokes are just undermined by the lack of blood. Like, there's entire chunks of this movie involving the vicious killing of tons of people, but so much of it is barely on screen to hold on to that PG-13 rating. Just as an example, there's a reoccurring joke in this movie about crushing people's skulls and splattering their brains out, but you don't really get that payoff. So if you're gonna get the setup, but no payoff, then why even make the joke if you're not gonna commit, you know what I mean? Like, especially with Matthew Vaughn's usually rated R movies with extremely over-the-top violence, I'm not sure why this movie decides to do away with that. It could be that maybe the studio actually watched the movie and was like, holy shit, this movie's gonna fucking bomb. We gotta try and salvage this and make as much money as possible. Yo, re-edit it, make it PG-13. I mean, I don't know if it went down like that, but it sort of feels like that, you know what I mean? Like, especially if you've seen the movie, you know what I'm talking about. You'll know what I mean when you watch it. Which leads me to something else that I want to talk about, and that is this movie's marketing. I've been seeing a lot of people online complaining about how they felt misled and how the trailers fooled them into thinking that Henry Cavill is going to be the main character. But like, I don't know, I'm sorry, but if you saw this trailer and thought that Henry Cavill was going to be the main character, I mean this in the nicest way possible, but you're fucking stupid. The trailers made it painfully obvious that Henry Cavill wasn't going to be in the movie that much, and that he's just a fictional character in Ellie Conway's book series.
Because you're a goddamn fortune teller, Ellie. What you wrote in your new book actually happened, and you kicked a hornet's nest you didn't even know existed.
Though, I will concede to the posters of this movie being misleading. If you didn't see the trailers and only saw this poster, then yeah, I mean, I could totally see how you'd feel misled. Because, I mean, imagine if you have no idea what this movie is, and you look at this poster, who would you guess to be the main character? Yeah, that's right, the two people who are hidden the fuck away off to the side, not the dude who's in the center of the poster, or even the three people who are in the center of the poster. No. It's these two people. And for those who watch my channel, you guys know that I never bitch and moan about bad CGI. I tend to dismiss bad effects because I'm so focused on like the writing, editing, and performances of a movie. If something looks fake, whatever, because it is fake. Whether or not something looks real doesn't really affect my viewing experience like 99% of the time. But man, Argylle legit has some of the worst looking green screen I've ever seen in a modern day big budgeted movie. Like, remember when everyone was bitching about how bad The Flash looked last year? And yeah, again, that movie looks super fake, but at least in those sequences, everything was CG. I mean, I'd rather watch an entire sequence that's obviously CGI than watch real people stand around in the fakest looking shit you've ever seen. For instance, the opening scene of the movie looked so fake that it truly took me out of the movie. And by the way, this whole scene is ripped straight out of Uncharted 4 and subsequently Police Story, but done far worse. Far, far worse. I mean, if you watch the scene from Police Story, and then you watch the scene from Argylle, it is night and fucking day. And again, I very rarely bat an eye at bad CGI or bad green screen, but I just couldn't not acknowledge it in this review. It was so noticeable throughout the entire movie. And now just for some closing thoughts here, really all I have to say is that I would have preferred to watch an actual movie of Henry Cavill and John Cena in a buddy spy thriller. The opening scene was so cheesy and goofy when it was working and had such a style that I actually wanted to see more of it. And eventually, the movie does bleed into that same level of cheesy goofiness, like the concept of the real world, quote-unquote, slowly becoming this insanely ridiculous spy thriller that our main character is writing about is a very cool idea. But the fake spy movie was just more fun to watch than the real spy movie that we got. I really wanted to like this movie, guys, because at its core, I think it's got a really good thing going. I think it's really well edited, it's got a great tone, and I enjoyed stylistic choices for the most part. Like, this movie is ridiculous, but in a good way. I really enjoyed how fucking stupid this movie allowed itself to be at times, but it's just missing something.
and I couldn't really tell you what. I ultimately, at the end of the day, would recommend Argylle, but probably just for a one-time watch. It's a good one-time watch. I enjoyed it. I had fun, but I don't think I'll be revisiting it anytime soon. Let's go.